Good morning, guys, and welcome back to The Flame.
Let's see what we have for today's Teacher Friday.
Good morning, guys, and welcome to today's Feature Friday. I'm here with one of our new 6th grade ELA teachers, Mrs. Moberg, and I'm going to be asking her a few questions so we can get to know her. So, Ms. Moberg, my first question for you is, where did you grow up?
I grew up in South Florida, the Fort Lauderdale area.
What made you decide you wanted to be a teacher?
Well, I first wanted to be an equine vet. That is, I've ridden horses my whole life, but my vet said that he did not think it would be a good fit for me because it's really hard to have a family if you're an equine vet. And so my next love was kids, and that's when I decided to become a teacher.
That's great. What do you like to do for fun?
Well, I have horses. I try to ride, but most of my time is occupied with baseball because 2 out of my 3 boys play travel ball and high school ball. So we're pretty busy with that.
Gotcha. What college did you graduate from?
I graduated from Mercer University, and that's in Macon, Georgia.
Can you give us a fun fact about yourself?
A fun fact. I love to run, and I run with my 2 big dogs, and that is just something that I enjoy after a long day of teaching. And I another fun fact is I really enjoy my students. We have a good time while we're learning, and I like to use a lot of humor in my teaching. So shout out to all my 6th grade students. You're the best.
All right, cool. Thank you so much for your time, and welcome to WMHS. Now we're going to go back to you, Alyssa and Jemiah.
Thanks, Leslie. JROTC Picture Day is Monday. And also, students and staff, if you didn't have your picture taken, you will also need to have your picture taken on Monday.
Hey, don't forget to read A Land Remembered and pass the test by October 22nd if you want to be in A Land Remembered Day. Oh, and a Southern Meat Heritage fundraiser is due today to Mr. Skipper or Ms. Cooey.
That looks like that's all for The Flame today. See you guys next week.
In a world before there were skyscrapers.
A world before Mickey Mouse and Walt Disney.
Before there was a McDonald's on every single corner.
Imagine a place where there were no cell phones, no smartwatches, no Fortnite.
A world where you could call the wilderness your home.
Your means for surviving was hunting in the wild.
A Land Remembered, written by Patrick D. Smith, does just that. It takes you back into the early 1900s and takes an in-depth look at Florida's changing landscape and economy.
The story begins with 25-year-old Tobias McIvory, who could feel the impending Civil War. So he sold his land in southern Georgia and took his wife Emma and young baby Zach into the eastern scrub of Florida in hopes of avoiding the war.
Follow one family's 3 generation in their journey into A Land Remembered. Check out the book today, read it, and enjoy it. Take a simple test, see Ms. Cooey or Ms. Dola, and you could find out firsthand what it is like in A Land Remembered.
Willis Middle High School will recreate the old Florida setting during the late 1800s to early 1900s. You'll have the opportunity to taste some swamp cabbage, wild boar sausage, and huckleberry jam, just to mention a few of the foods that were eaten in Florida during the late 1800s. As though that is not enough, you could rope some cows, learn about branding, and possibly churn your own butter. So grab a book, A Land Remembered by Patrick D. Smith, pass a test, and come join us at WMHS's A Land Remembered Day, November 15th. Ask Mrs. Cooey or Mrs. Dola for details.
So don't forget, read the novel, A Land Remembered, and test on the novel by October 22nd.
up with someone, so why do I bite my tongue? Ooh, I wanna know ya.